Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 17, practice test 4, section 3, no calculator. Okay, found in the new SAT official study guide. So, in the triangle above, the sine of x is 0.6. What is the cosine of y? Right, so first of all, sine of x, before we find that, we need to find the angle x, which is this. Right, and this is the right triangle because whenever we deal with trigonometry, we always deal with right triangles, right? Meaning triangles that have an angle that is 90 degrees. One of the angles is 90 degrees in measure, okay, which is this angle here, right? That's why it's a right triangle, and that's why trigonometry, right triangle trigonometry, makes sense here, okay? So, angle x, right? This is angle x, and as you know, the sine of x means opposite side divided by the hypotenuse, right? What is the opposite side of angle x? It's the side, right? This is the opposite side of angle x, so that means that sine of x is this side divided by the hypotenuse, the longest side, right? This side divided by the hypotenuse. So now let's see what that means. 0.6 can be expressed as 6 divided by 10, right? Because this is 6 tenths, so that means 6 over 10 is 0.6. So 6 over 10 means opposite over hypotenuse, right? So that means that this side is 6 in length, and the hypotenuse is 10 in length, right? Now we need to determine the cosine of y. Right, and y angle here measuring y degrees is this angle, right, as indicated in the triangle. Now the cosine of y would be the adjacent over the hypotenuse, right, and the hypotenuse will be the same because that's the longest side. So adjacent will not be this side opposite of the y, but it would be this side, and this is adjacent of the y angle, right? Adjacent divided by the hypotenuse. Now this is something familiar to you, right? Because as we calculated earlier, as we noted earlier, sine of x was this side divided by the hypotenuse, right? And it turns out the cosine of y is also this side divided by the hypotenuse, right? And that makes sense because if you know in right triangle trigonometry, if sine of x and cosine of x are equal, right? That means that x plus y is equal to 90 degrees. And that makes sense because the angle measure sum of y and x is going to be 90 degrees because you have 90 left over to make 180, right? The sum of all interior angles. So that makes sense. So if you know that property, you can actually avoid all this work and arrive at the answer to be 6 over 10 as well, because you know that since x plus y is equal to 90, sine of x is equal to cosine of y. You can take any single angle, even use your calculator, you'll know that, let's say, sine of 45, right? Sine of 45 is equal to cosine of 45. Or sine of 30 is equal to cosine of 60. And sine of 60 is equal to cosine of 30. Right? So you know the angle measures, a sum of x and y is going to be always 90 degrees. Right? So that means that the sine of this guy will always equal cosine of this guy and the other way around. Okay? So you can avoid all this work, but even if you didn't know that property, you could have arrived at the answer this way, right? Determine what the opposite side is, determine what the hypotenuse is, and it's exactly the same thing because the cosine of y is also this side divided by this side, even though adjacent, but since y is a different angle, adjacent happens to be the opposite side of the angle x, right? The adjacent side of angle y is the same side as the opposite side of angle x. This is why sine of x is equal to cosine of y. And you can grid this in as 0.6, right? Because you can't include the zero if you take the paper exam, right? Or you can grid in 3 divided by 5, right? This is the simplified fraction from coming from 6 over 10, because 6 over 10 can be simplified using the greatest common factor of 6 and 10, which is 2, right? So you divide both the numerator and the denominator by 2, you arrive at 3 over 5th, right? 3 over 5.